So here we are. Welcome. My name is Sue Wilhite, and this is a webinar on untriggering, how to lose unwanted thoughts that are plaguing you, whether they are thoughts of a person or a situation or something, some kind of negative thought that you find going around and around in your head unwanted. If you want to control those negative thoughts, this is a very easy three-step process. I teach this to my clients all the time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to describe the three steps, and then at the end I will describe why it works. I found that some people need to know that information and others just want to jump right in and get the technique and get it over with. So if you practice this technique at least for 30 days, most of the time it takes less than that, but if you practice for at least 30 days, then you will be rid of whatever negative thoughts that you are trying to get rid of. Now, I recommend that you only pick one unwanted thought that you are trying to get rid of. Do not try to do this for multiple thoughts at a time. It's easier for you and far better success if you do it for one thought at a time. So, the three steps are focus your awareness, change the thought, and think of something positive. Now, I'm going to expand that, unpack it, as you will. And so, the first step is to focus your awareness. This is by far the hardest part of the whole process. I cannot emphasize this. This is the tough part, is noticing when you are in the middle of the negative thought. So for instance, many times people come to me because there is someone in their life that has just broken up with them or has passed on or has had some kind of negative impact. And for whatever reason, my clients are, I'll call it obsessing about that person, and they can't stop thinking about them. And what you need to do is notice when you are thinking about them. Notice when their name crosses your mind. Notice when you are, something reminds you of them. And that is the first step, but it is the hardest. Absolutely, no question, it is the hardest to catch those thoughts, to notice. And what's going to happen is that as you start practicing this, you'll discover that you were actually thinking about this person or the situation, or you're having this negative thought and it's been going on for a period of time. You've had this long time and you suddenly notice that you've been thinking about them or whatever the thought is. Don't be concerned with how long it is or that you may have thought about it yesterday and you just realized it. Don't go there. That's just adding another negative thought to the mix. So what you want to do is you want to just notice. That's the first step. The second step is changing your awareness. So changing to a negative thought, to another thought. The difference here, many people will say, take your negative thought and just switch it over to a positive thought. Just think of something positive. Well, this doesn't work, and I will mention afterwards when I talk about why it doesn't work and why my technique actually does work. So what you want to do is you want to shift your thought to something neutral, something that you have absolutely no attachment to, either positive or negative. My favorite thing is a door hinge. Most people have absolutely no association with a door hinge whatsoever. And so that is my favorite one to use as a what you're going to think about. So I'm going to use door hinge. You can pick whatever it is, but it needs to be absolutely neutral. You can think of a wall. You can think of the ceiling. You can think of anything. Anything that you have an absolutely neutral response to. There cannot be any positive association, and there absolutely cannot be any negative association with it. So you think of this neutral thought, and that there's two tricks to this. The first trick is that you must switch to thinking about it immediately, which means that you already have to pick it ahead of time. When you notice yourself having the negative thought, you don't want to do something like, oh, gee, I wonder what that was that I was supposed to be thinking of, or let me think of something. No, you want to immediately switch over to whatever it is. So let's pick door hinge for the moment. You notice that you're having a negative thought. You immediately start thinking about a door hinge. You start thinking about what it looks like. Does it? How many lines does it have in there? Is it securely connected to the door that you're thinking of? Is it a brass hinge? Is it a silver hinge? Is it a stainless steel hinge? Is it one of those big hunking hinges that you see like in bank vaults? What kind of a hinge is it? What does it smell like? What if you were to, for some strange reason, happen to lick it? What does it taste like? What is it? What every sensory experience that you could have about that door hinge, what does it feel like? Is it hot or is it cold? Is it smooth? Is it rough? How big is it? Is it, like I said, a big hunking door hinge, or is it just a little tiny hinge? Or is it a little hinge on a box somehow? What kind of a hinge is it? And you want to spend at least 2 or 3 minutes totally immersing yourself in the experience of this neutral thought, in our example, the door hinge. Totally think of that door hinge. And then, only then, can you go to step three, which is the positive thought. The positive thought, again, you want to pick something in advance that is going to be your positive thought. And you want it to be something that is emotionally uplifting. So for me, I happen to like sunrises. So I think about the sun coming up. Or I'll think about a flower blooming in my rose garden. Or I'll think about one of my animals, one of my cats or my dogs. I'll think about something really cool. There's a local Japanese garden that I just adore going to. I'll think about going there when all of the flowers are in bloom and how wonderful that makes me feel. So you want to think about something that is real, something that has a visual, possibly an auditory, possibly some other kind of sensory experience. And you want to shift from the neutral to the positive. And again, just like in the neutral, you want to immerse yourself in that positive experience. You want to just feel it completely. You want to notice what it tastes like, what it smells like, what it looks like, what it sounds like, all of that. And you want to immerse yourself, as I said, completely in that positive experience. Now, once you have done that and you're in the positive experience a little bit, there are some bonus things that you can do. The basic technique is notice, bring into your awareness that you're having the negative thought. You shift to a neutral thought, and then you shift to a positive thought. Now, to really anchor that positive thought, there are some things that you can do that will help, but they're not necessary, and if it's not safe for you to do it, in other words, if when you're noticing the negative thought or the unwelcome image, you're driving or you're at work or something like that where you really can't do that, then please don't. Like I said, these are bonuses. They work really well to help enhance, and I do recommend them, but don't do it if it's not safe, okay? So, bonus number one, while you are thinking of the positive thought, look up and raise your arms. That's bonus number one. While you're thinking of the positive thought, so for instance, if I was thinking of a sunrise, or one of my flowers. I would think about that for a while and really get into, oh, I love the sunrise because I love that feeling of that crisp, sort of cold air just before the sun comes up, that beautiful light that is right on the horizon as the sun is coming up, this fresh smell, the feeling that the sun is coming up. There is an emotional response for me that the sun is coming up. Perhaps some birds are starting to sing. There's more activity in the world. People are starting to wake up. There's just this uplifting feeling. And at that point, now that I've gotten totally immersed into it and I've fully brought it into my experience, I can take a deep breath and raise my head, look up, and raise my arms. The second bonus thing that you can do, and it's going to be a little tough for me to demonstrate in this particular environment, is you want to stand up if you're not already standing. And again, if you're driving, don't do this. And you want to stand up and actually march in place. So you move your arms back and forth, parallel with your forearms, parallel with the ground, just moving back and forth. And you want to lift your legs up so that your thighs are parallel to the ground as well. So you're marching, but you're kind of high marching. So your thighs actually lift up. And you can just do that in place, your thighs going and your arms going. And you do that for several minutes. And that's another bonus that allows you to really reinforce that positive feeling and immersion. And as much as you possibly can, while you are doing that marching motion, you want to still be in that feeling, that positive immersion that you're in. And that whole process, the step one, step two, step three, step one, finding your awareness and noticing that thought, step two, shifting to the neutral thought, and step three, shifting to the positive thought, can take as little as 3 minutes. It really doesn't take very long, and you might end up having to do it multiple times per day, but at the very least, it doesn't take very long to do each one. And you just practice it. You just keep practicing. And it feels at first like it's not going to work. And then suddenly you notice that there's these longer and longer stretches where you're not thinking about them. And something will remind you and you'll go, wow, I haven't thought about that person or that situation for almost a day. And that's when you know it's working. And I have absolutely seen this happen with multiple clients. I have done it myself. And practiced it myself, and it really, really works. And it's just a very simple three-step process. Now, how does it work? For those of you who don't care how it works, you can just tune out right now. But for those of you who are curious, there is actually some brain, some actual neuroscience behind this. Here's the deal. When you have a thought, there is a neuron pathway that gets set in your brain. If you start to have a thought over and over again, the brain is really efficient and it wants to hoard energy. So when it's hoarding energy, when it's doing energy, it wants to create a pathway that it knows how to get to. It's like a shortcut. So if you have a situation that reminds you of something else, or you've started to have a thought of someone, what's going to happen is your brain is going to start to create a shortcut. It's a neural packet, and these neurons are all going to get associated with each other, and it's actually going to create what's called a myelin sheath around these neurons, and it's like an electrical bundle or a network bundle. And the brain is conserving energy by doing this because the brain has figured out, as it were, that these neurons tend to bunch together. And so it's going to bunch them. And every time you have the thought, it's going to go straight there. And this is why it is so hard to control those thoughts, because they're already bundled. They're already together. And it takes very little to trigger the firing of all of these things together. Therefore, and this is why, trying to just shift from a negative to a positive thought is really, really hard, because the positive thoughts have their own neural bundle. They have their own pathways and their own triggers. And they're usually pretty far apart because they have different responses in the body. And the brain does not want to get the two mixed up. So they're pretty far away. So it's a little bit like you're going down a road and the road branches, and you're going to go down this road, the negative road, and here you are, you're going down the negative road, and suddenly you want to get to the positive road, but the positive road, you know, you've gone way out here in the negative, and the positive is way over here. You're going to have to, you know, turn the car and screech over to the positive, and it takes a lot of effort, and your brain is going to resist doing that. So what you want to do is you want to take like the first turnoff that you can, which is the neutral thought, and it's going to be significantly closer to the positive thought. The other thing, moving from the negative thought to the neutral thought, does is it actually starts to break up that neural bundle. And the neural bundle starts to go, well, it's really not worth it for the brain to keep these things together if you're always going to be going off and doing something else. So it starts to disengage these neural bundles. Now you're in the neutral. Now you can go onto the positive thought road and start associating that with whatever the original trigger is, and the brain will, over time, start to just go to the positive or just go to the neutral, and it will all be dissipated. All of the negativity will be dissipated, or a good chunk of it will be dissipated. This is why it works. It's all brain chemistry. So, and the way that the brain works and the way that neurons bundle together. So this is why it works. This is why it is so important for you to go from the negative thought, noticing the negative thought, going to the neutral thought, and then going to the positive thought. And the more activity that you do in your body with the positive thought, the better it works. The more it sort of locks in that that positive thought in the way that it can. So, thank you so much for joining me. I very much appreciate this, and I really, really hope that you are able to use this technique and be able to rid yourself of any unwanted negative thoughts. To your success, this is Sue Wilhite, CEO of Positively Success. Thank you so much for joining me.